Hi everyone, I am Amit and I am working as a data engineer in the Google, and I have done various projects and on data engineering side, data science, ML model, and today I will going to take your class on AWS and IoT. So hope this session will be quite interesting and we will learn a lot. And meanwhile, if you have any question regarding this AWT IoT, the lab that we're going to see today, if you have any doubt on that, please feel free to ask to me while the session. So meanwhile, just I wanted to know like what is covered till now, and can you just give me the brief? Like, are you comfortable to do this AWS lab or learning? Any one of you?
Hi. Actually, we have started implementing that IoT Greengrass thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that stack part could not connect. So we were in between that. So Devan shared like we will start it from scratch for the next class.
Yes.
We have created one workshop named IoT workshop, something like that, on Cloud9. And then we have created environment where that couldn't happen.
Okay. So let me just share my screen and open that. So how is your like while working with AWS, is it looking complex or interesting to work on this AWS cloud? And do you have
Actually, we didn't do anything much like quantity work till now on IoT AWS. So since last three sessions, we were just trying to implement that thing and that couldn't happen. So really no say till this point, I think.
Okay.
I find it very interesting as well as complicated. I have been researching a lot about AWS and its scope. It is very interesting, but I do get stuck at various points. So could you help me understand the small device which we need for IoT Greengrass? There was a small microchip kind of thing.
XMP something, that name was XMP something.
Yeah. So there are a lot of IoT devices are there that based on this Greengrass IoT. So actually the thing is that why we are using this, so that we can send the real-time data that are collecting through sensors or smart devices, IoT devices, to the cloud. Just like you might have done work with the remotes, like AC remotes or TV remote. So there also we are just sending the sensor right to the TV. So just like the TV, our cloud is also the collector. You can say it like the data are collecting. You need something to collect the data, and because the data size are increasing day by day as we are doing more and more operations, we are doing more stuff on the data. So we need something, right? So that's why we use this cloud. Now you can, it means the question can be come to your mind also, like why we use cloud, why not the local storage? So there's some restriction, right? Means the storage usually have some limitation, and it's very costly to purchase storage every time. So you need some cloud device, or like you need some cloud storage where you can save this. And this IoTs and all are used, they are just like a gateway to connect to the several smart devices that are based on this IoT, where we will get the data from several sources. So it's just like a repository, or you can say it a data from collecting from a several sources and ingesting to the single platform. Am I clear to you? In a simple way, I have explained you what IoT Greengrass and why do we use it. And if you have anything, if you want to know more on this, you can simply go to this AWS document about this, what is the AWS IoT, and whatever I explain you, exactly the same thing. It's like it allow you to connect several devices together, and like when you are connecting this in the cloud, you can able to manage the device. You can manage the edges in the sense connection between the devices. Am I clear to you?
Yes, you are. Could you please start recording this session, please?
Yeah, it's recording. It's
okay, perfect.
It's on the recording and I will going to upload it also.
Lovely. Thank you.
Thank you. So as I said,
One more question. If we are going to have this hypothetical project, where are we going to collect the data from?
Hypothetical project in the sense like, can you give me the brief?
I wrote my notes somewhere.
What kind of project you are talking about?
Give me 1 second.
So as you can see on the screen, as I explained you, as you can see here, from this graph or like from this image, it might be somewhat clear to you, like this is the cloud. And with the help of this IoT green grass code, how you are connecting the several devices, smart devices, or with the help of some components and the service of an AWS, like AWS Lambda messaging system, Shadow and AWS Security, EC2, creating an instance. So with the help of this AWS services, you will going to create a kind of a connection between those several services. Services in the sense, like, see, it's a kind of pipeline. Pipeline in the sense, like, if I explain you in the deep, how it will be, just one. So actually the thing is that, like, suppose several devices are there. Just 1 minute, let me open the paint. Yeah, it's open. So normally what usually happens, a kind of AWS is a cloud. Suppose this is your AWS cloud. And inside this AWS, you are using this to collect the data from several sources, right? So here is one component that is called IoT green grass. You can, this one that I have discussed now, this green grass IoT component. So this AWS IoT green grass is actually used to install some components, services that will going to help you to collect the data from several sources. It is similar to like a, you have a central system, suppose you have a central hard disk and you are ingesting the data from several sources, like suppose from one system, two system, three system, four system, and those data are not only the like a batch data means fixed data, like you have written the text file yesterday and you are moving to it. What about the real data in the sense that are coming in a real time? Means it is not saved somewhere, you are directly ingesting into this AWT IoT green grass. So this component will going to help you to connect to the several devices. It's like a platform. It's giving you a kind of gateway that will help you to install several devices. What actually they do, it is a gateway. Gateway in the sense, you can think it like just like a kind of a entry point, you can say it. Or it's like a beginning that used to install several software. And once you install this software, you can connect several devices and make a communication between them. Just like you and me, we are communicating, right? So what was making our communication successful? That is your Zoom, right? So this Zoom is allowing us to communicate, right? In the same way, this AWT IoT green grass is also a component that will allow you to install several software. Those software are helpful for making a connection with smart devices and help us to ingest the data and save the data, because the data size is obviously will increase day by day as we do more operation. So it is a gateway, you can say, this IoT green glass, AWS one, that allow you to make communication between several devices. So this is a just general idea. I will going to show you the lab also. Is it clear to you, ma'am? That what the general definition, the small introduction that I have given to you. Am I clear with this? What actually this IoT green grass, why we use it?
Yes.
Yes.
I got it. So in the previous session with Devanshu, he said that we were going to create industrial data platform.
Yes, yes.
My question for you is where, how about the data part? Like where were we about to get the data from?
Data, actually you will get it from the devices. Whatever the devices that we will going to use in the smart devices, IoT base, they use some sensor. So those sensors, they give you the data in the form of infrared signals or some signals that will going to operate on. When, if you have seen, when you press any, your remote, when you press it, there is one sensor is there at the top, diode, or we usually say, when you press it, it's red light blinks on that. It is actually sending the infrared signal to the system. So that signal is actually the data, which is in the form of a signal. If it is in, it is in the analog signal, binary signal, you can say, that data will going to receive by your devices. There actually it was TV. Here actually we are using same, you can see on my system, you can see this image, these devices are there, some circuits, and you can say these smart circuits are there, which will going to help you to accept the input or accept the data. So the data you are talking about, it is in the form of analog signal, or it can be in the form of binary signal, you can say it, that will going to accept by your devices, which once you do this lab part, so you will come to know what are the things we needed in order to configure this. So in this exercise one, what actually the thing we have to do is, we need to install the instances. Instance in the sense, you can think it as a system, just like your window you are using, right? So in the cloud, it is something like an instance that that will going to provide you certain space, certain memory. Okay, suppose if I say you, instance one. So instance one is whatever, it's instance one is like a OS system. You can think it as an operating system that will going to provide you a certain RAM, maybe suppose 10 GB RAM, and they will going to provide you 1 TB hard disk. And they will provide you suppose i9 processor, CPU, right? So this is called as an instance. Instance is like a system they are providing you. So we will going to create one instance. Once we create an instance, we will going to deploy everything on that. So this you can decide it, like how much space you want to give it. Is EC2 instances is done in the class? Has they given any introduction on that? Or do you know about it, EC2 instances? Have you created an instance before?
No.
Okay. Do you know about these instances? What is instance?
No.
Okay. So as I said, you instance is nothing but a kind of a machine, you can say, which is having some configuration. As I said, you an operating system. Suppose the laptop that you are using, it is having some configuration, right? So you have this instance can be created based on your requirement. Now suppose this is used by Swarnita ma'am, instance is used by instance one is used by Swarnita ma'am, and suppose Dipti ma'am, she is using instance two. So instance two, suppose she want a system with only 4 GB data, she don't want that, she doesn't having a requirement, and 4 GB of data, 4 GB of RAM she want, system with RAM 4 GB, and if she want hard disk also 250 GB, because 250 GB she want. She doesn't having much requirement, and the processor she want i5. So this is you call instance to, okay, based on the requirement you can create a system. So in this instance you can do several operation, right? You can execute your machine learning code. You can use this instance to run your project. You can deploy your project. You can do this green grass IoT installation on this, right? So this is called the instance. Similarly, like Manju ma'am, if you want, she can create another instance. Any name she can give it to this instance name. And what even this operating system also you can decide it. Suppose Swarnita ma'am, she want Linux. You want suppose Mac. Dipti ma'am, she want Windows. So this is called as an instance. Once you create this instance, after that you can do this AWT IoT green grass, means in whichever system configuration you want to have this AWS IoT green grass to work, that you can decide it. So this is the thing behind the instance. AWS, we have a EC2 instance, and this instance keyword you are going to find out in various AWS services. So here you will going to use some component while working with AWS Greengrass. As you can see here, it is showing you that some of the services that you might need it while working with this AWT Greengrass code. You can call it as a Greengrass also. That messaging devices, Lambda is one service. Security you need it. IoT Greengrass component you need to establish or configure, and you need to make a connection between them so that you can send the data, receive the data. And you can see here, these are some of the device type. Are you able to see, ma'am? So this these are the different devices which will going to get the data or interact with this core component. Just like server is sending a data on this component, and this component will going to forward you. So it is like a mediator, you can say it, where you will going to do everything. You will going to install the component, you will going to make a connection between them, you will going to install a software here, and then based on the configuration, once you are done, you can connect the devices. Now is it somewhat, I think you might get an idea how actually it works. So this cloud will be an AWS that is providing you the platform to configure this IoT Greengrass, and then with the help of and then we can connect with the devices. So for that, whatever the component that you need it, you need something to do configuration. What are the things, like you can see here, you can see local message and trigger. It means that message will be going to be received by this IoT component, IoT Greengrass, like the signal that you are going to send, whether it is received by the machine or not. So it will going to accept that, right? Am I clear to you, or like it's looking complex?
I think we are following properly.
Like if you are not getting anything, or like if you are getting difficulty to understand what I'm saying, you can please feel free to ask. I can show you, I come to the lab part, but before that, if you are clear with this concept, then we can move it to. Don't go in a much deep on this, otherwise you will get confused on that. Just think it like you are using this AWS cloud, and this AWS cloud is providing one service, IoT Greengrass component, and this services will going to be used to connect several devices. That device can be your smart devices, right? Just like as I said, you it will be like smart city. Okay, so in that smart city you are using home devices, you are using some component like automatic door closing or cameras that is based on a signal, right? So some of these devices you will need it to connect that. Am I clear to you, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay. So this is actually, we use this IoT green grass component, and you can see this here. It's nothing, but it's just telling you what actually the flow is, how you are doing this. See, once you make an account in this cloud, hope you all have an account in AWS, right?
Yes.
So once you have an account in AWS, just start exploring on the services. Exploring on the services in the sense, there are different services are there. Once you click on this, you can get an options that what are the different services. Once you click on this service, you can see this EC2, Lambda, Elastic Beanstalk, and this all machine learning, cost management, web development part, container. So this all you will get it. These are the different services, database, what is a migration. So these all services are there. So this green grass component, that IoT green grass component, as I said you. So this is also one component that is used to run your code that will help you to make a connection with the smart devices. Okay. Let me explain you in more easier way.
Did we cover edge computing? Is it part of what we will be doing?
Yeah. So, but today we are doing the exercise based on that. And then later on, we can do it edge computing and all. So here, ma'am, as you can see here, okay, first let me come to the brief introduction part. So you are saying that how we are doing that. This edge devices is how you connect to the several devices on the cloud and how you can make a communication between them. So this is step by step it is giving. Like edge devices, it's nothing like you want to connect the devices and perform some operation. So here this ESP32 is a kind of edge device, you can say it. Means it will going to help you to store the files, to store the data. The data that will be either in analog signal and that you will receive from some diode or some signals that are like from remote or from smart devices, and even automatic locking of the car door, right? And smart devices are there in the car also. They are also based on, you can say it like this, AWS and IoT. So this is the data are going to some on the cloud somewhere. And let's start about doing that practical based on that. So this AWS IoT, if you want to explore more, you can go to this document. I'm going to share you on the chat. You can note down if you want to explore more, you can go through it. And in case, if you are not clear anything, you can ask me anytime. In the short, I have given you the brief idea, like what actually this Greengrass AWT, as I said you, it allow you to install a software, and it's a kind of gateway that will help you to connect the edges, devices to your Greengrass component, which are based on IoT. And then you will going to use some services to deploy your code and to make running of the smart devices successfully. Okay, ma'am, it is something like in the short, I have given you example. Let me explore you in more. It's not difficult, it's easy only, but it might be because you are learning first time, that's why it's looking complex. It is nothing but this is suppose an AWS IoT, and this is inside the cloud only. Now, you are going to do it here, you are going to configure this green grass component. You will make a configuration of this IoT. So once you do the configuration, so several devices like smart devices like automatic car door locking, okay, or home appliance, smart home appliance, which are based on IoT, and suppose for further operations, suppose army based IoT device. So this all, they can send the data to this cloud. Sorry, I have looked door it is. So this automatic car door, right? So once you configure it, once you install or make a configuration of this AWS IoT Greengrass, you can then send or you can connect to the several home devices and appliance, and then you can send the data to it. Means it will go into make a communication, and then you can save the data inside the cloud. So this will be like a, it will provide you an instance. So here, in this AWS, whatever instances you will create, based on that, it will save the data. Suppose Manju ma'am, she has made this project, and like Swarnita ma'am, she create this one, and suppose Dipti ma'am, she create this project. Okay, so suppose if they create this project and they want an instance, so suppose instance once is used by Manju ma'am, instance 2 by Swanita ma'am, and suppose instance 3 is there. So based on your requirement, this data will going to be saved in the cloud. Like suppose smart home appliance not need much memory, 4 GB is sufficient. So it will be saved in such a storage, which is having RAM of 4 GB or system of 4 GB, 250 GB of hard disk. So this all data, whatever data will be generated by this project or this software or this devices, I should say devices, not project, the devices that you are using for car locking, smart home appliance, and army base, this all will be going to save it here. So then in that case, you don't need to manage the data. So this, how you are going to do that? In that case, you need to do some configuration, right? You need to install some software. You just need some software to be installed on this cloud, so that you can make a connection between those, and you need to deploy this in the cloud, deploy this whole code that you have written for this IoT connection between cloud and this device. You need to deploy it in the AWS cloud. Deploy in the sense, once you are done the project, you need to make it available to the public, right, for the use. So how you are going to make it available? You need to deploy it on some cloud, or just like a website. When you click on website, you can see that website, right? Similarly, this software is also deployed on some software, or you can say it on some cloud, maybe AWS, GCP, Azure. So once you deploy it, it will be ready to use. Is it clear? Do you understand the flow? Like this, these are all smart devices that what they are doing, they are sending the data here.
How do we do, what's the definition of instance? Like, how do I explain what is instance?
Instance in the sense, based on your requirement, you create a configuration for your operations, or you can task. If anyone asks you what is an instance, instance is like a, on the cloud, virtual system you are creating, just like a laptop. So the laptop that you are using and I am using to connect, I am having Windows 10, I am having 16 GB RAM, I am having 1 TB hard disk, I am having i9 processor. Suppose tomorrow I need a i12, suppose in the market they declare i12, they introduce i12, I want i12. So purchasing i12, will it be a solution for me, right solution? No. Why? Because the cost of i9 or i12 is very huge, right? So suppose after every project, if my requirement get changed, I need to purchase new laptop, right? But if you use this virtual system on the cloud instances, you can upgrade your memory, your storage, your CPU easily. You don't need that. I will going to show you that only. you can easily upgrade this. Now suppose Swanita ma'am, she want for this smart home, suppose she don't want 10 GB, she want 20 GB RAM. So will she will going to purchase every time new laptop as the new project will be assigned to her? No. And same for you also, like Manju ma'am and Dipti ma'am. So here, what we do it, we create a instance on the cloud. This instance can be easily upgraded. So instance can be easily upgraded in term of storage, that is your hard disk, in term of memory, in term of computing, that is your CPU, and in term of server also, means where the data will going to be saved, that server region. Do you know the region and all? What is region and what is zone in the cloud? Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Do you know the region and zone in the cloud? It is something that you want to save your data in certain region. You want to save your data on US server so that it can be easily accessible to the US America citizen. If you want to save on a Mumbai is one region in India. If you want to save it in a Mumbai server, then it is accessible to the in India. Suppose Asian region, European region. So just like we deploy a server on certain region, then it's on you. Wherever you want to save a data, you can save it. So instance means you are creating a virtual system with this configuration. So I think we should we have okay. So as we have a limitation on this Zoom, I will going to share on the Trello another Zoom link. Can you connect after this, like once this 4 minute is over?
Yeah.
Okay. So now let's start about this setup, how to configure the setup. Just 1 minute. As I was saying you about the instance, right? So here, this is in AWS. If you type instance, you can click on this EC2. And here you can create a virtual server. Virtual server means virtual system, you can create it. Instances, when you click on this, you can decide the configuration based on your requirement. You can create here. Click on launch instances. Then this is the option they are giving. Amazon Linux and Mac OS. And this are the all details about it. Like it provide Linux kernel. It provide like this is the details. If 64 bit OS, and this kind of details you will find it. Similarly, Mac OS, there are different kind of instances are available. These are the different name. Once you click on this select, that instance will be get created for you. Ubuntu server, Microsoft Windows, 64-bit ARM, like this you will get it, 32-bit, 64-bit. And suppose if you want to do deep learning operation, you can get it. This kind of instance, you can use it. Deep learning is a kind of neural network, machine learning based, data science based, deep learning. There are some, it will provide you library also. You don't need to do that. GPU will be available, graphic processing unit. So these all instance you can, once you click on this select, it will get create for you. And the reason that I said means, where you want to deploy your server, you can click it from here and you can select Asia Pacific, Hong Kong, Mumbai, Osaka, Singapore, Sydney, wherever you want to create your virtual system, where the data will going to be saved, you can easily create it. So this is the way you can create the, you can connect it in various region. You can select it from here. Mostly we use this US is one, because this is a central US server having more configuration, more features are available in this. So we mostly use this one. But again, as I said, it depends on your requirement. You can create a Asia Pacific based on wherever you want to deploy the server. So this is all based on instances. So ma'am, I'm sending you the link. It's about only 30 minutes left. I'm sending you the link on this Trello again. Please join that. Is it fine?